Well, folks, welcome to Coffee and Revelation. The music you are hearing in the background is Bob Marley. In fact, let me just put that off. I will try and add that on to at the end here, because we're going to look at Babylon. We're at chapter 14 and verse 8 of Revelation. A second angel followed and said, "Fallen, fallen is Babylon the Great, which made all the nations drink the maddening wine of her adulteries." Well, what is this Babylon the Great, and why does the angel announce it, and how does it come in now? It's funny, the Ruts had a song, "Babylon's Burning," and in popular music culture, rock culture at least, Boney M, of course, Sam 137, "By the rivers of Babylon we sat and wept." Babylon has become, even today, it's associated with the idea of a corrupt system. The song I'll play at the end is Bob Marley's "Babylon System," again, if YouTube allow me to put it on. But, you know, it's very interesting how Marley considered Babylon to be the whole decadent West. Well, what's John speaking about here when he talks about Babylon the Great? I think he is talking about Rome and the Roman Empire, but I think above all, he's talking about the system of commerce. The ugliness, the perversity, the consumerism, the consumption that happens so much. And there's a system that's a Babylonic system. And he's saying it's fallen. All the nations drink the maddening wine of her adulteries. It's a world where people just care for material things. It's a world where people care for sensuality and they don't think about God. You know, I was reading in Isaiah 40, or thinking in Isaiah 40 this morning, about how the nations, surely the nations are a drop in the bucket. That God regards them as dust, that he considers the islands to be, you know, just dust again. And then he says that the Lord regards them as worthless, as less than nothing. And we have all these, you think of all the news and, you know, what's going on with the nations, with Russia, with Ukraine, with the UK, with the US, with Australia, with China, in Argentina, in Israel, in Canada, whatever. And this angel is coming saying the systems that they serve have fallen. Babylon's burning. Babylon's fallen. I actually think that's a very, very, very powerful image. And that's what we were thinking yesterday about how the judgment mixes with the good news. Paul in Romans 2:16, this will take place on the day when God judges people's secrets through Jesus Christ, as my gospel declares. I think we are to call people and nations to repentance. There is good news in letting people know that God will overcome evil, and that there's a day of judgment coming when the full strength of God's wrath is poured out. I think we live in a culture when so many, even evangelical Christians, struggle with that idea, as perhaps we should, but we mustn't reject it. Or in saying we are following Christ, we are rejecting what he himself has taught. If we reject the idea of judgment, we're rejecting what Christ himself taught. There is no rest, no peace for the wicked, but there is for the Lord's people, and the door is open for all. So Babylon is fallen, but Christ's church will rise. God bless you, and see you tomorrow. This, by the way, is from my office up at Moore College, and hopefully tomorrow, I think I've got my mic sorted, and we'll be back on the balcony. Bye. Oh, here's Babylon Burning, I meant to say. No, it's not. It's not Babylon's Burning. It's Bob Marley's Babylon System. I don't think you could stand the ruts. So this is Bob Marley's Babylon System. See you tomorrow. Bye.
what you wanted us to be. We are what we are. That's the way it's going to be. If you don't know, you can't educate us or no equal opportunity. Talking about my freedom, people freedom and liberty. Yeah, we've been starting on the wine press much too long. Rebel, rebel, yes, we've been trying on the wine press much too long. Rebel, rebel. Babylon system is the vampire. Yeah, vampire. Sucking the children day by day. Yeah, me say the Babylon system is the vampire. In the blood of the sufferer, yeah. Building church and university, oh yeah. Deceiving the people continually, yeah. Beside they're sucking the blood of the sufferer.